So let me show you what happens if I pick up the phone. 3, 2, 1.
Stop wasting time.
And now if I put the phone down. 안녕하십니까? 니콜라스입니다. And in this video, we are going to combat phone addiction using Arduino. As I told you before, I wanted to make Arduino projects. So today, we're going to build our first Arduino idea. So, what is the problem that I want to fix? The problem that I have right now is that when I'm working, I usually have my phone somewhere on my desk. Is that because my phone is so close to me, I usually just reach for my phone like this and immediately start doing stuff. This is what I want to stop. I want to stop wasting time and I want to stop literally reaching for my phone like a reflex. So that's what we're going to fix on this video. We are going to build an Arduino device that is going to hopefully stop me from doing this automatically, all right? All right, so for this video, I got myself an Arduino SATA kit from the internet. Now this comes with many stuff, including cables and also the Arduino and a breadboard. Now, the most important part of all this thing is this. This is a sensor, basically, that allows me to know how hard I am pressing it, if I'm touching it or not. And that's basically it. If I press super hard, I will get a value. If I don't press at all, I will get a value, okay? So here is how our machine is going to work. As you can see here, our Arduino has a power part, and it says here 5 volts, okay? So just for this example, let's imagine that electricity is just like water, okay? So the water is going to flow from here, is gonna go all the way to our breadboard. And here on the positive side, we're going to get water or electricity everywhere on this rail. Now we're gonna borrow some of that from here, and that is going to go all the way to our resistor. And if we are pressing, then the water is going to be able to flow all the way back and outside of the resistor. And then it's going to cross, it's gonna go to the negative side. And as you can see here, the negative side is then connected to our ground, all right? And that's basically it. Now, the important part here is that this is what is going to tell us if the circuit is working or not. So if I press, the water door will be open and the water will be able to flow. If I don't do that, then the water will basically stop here at the door and there will be no flow until the end of the circuit. And this cable is basically our spy, okay? This cable, as you can see here, it goes to analog input. Analog input is what is going to allow me to read from my computer if there is electricity flowing through the circuit. All right, so again, if we start a circuit here on 5 volts, we go here, we go all the way here, we borrow some of these. Here, if I'm not pressing anything, then this cable is going to read 0. If I am pressing, the cable is going to read something else. Now we have to do the code that is going to read from the analog input 0 of our Arduino. Okay, programming time. And actually, programming Arduino is super, super easy. Now, the cool thing is that Arduino has 2 functions, and already this programming language looks a little bit like C, so it's very easy to understand. So setup is basically a function that runs once at the beginning, and loop is a function that runs over and over and over and over again, as long as my Arduino has energy. I'm going to say serial that begin, and I want to begin communication super, super fast with my computer. And if you remember on the video I just showed you explaining the project, we connected our spy cable to the analog input A0. So now all I have to do is literally read from analog input A0, and that's it. I will get the value of how hard I am pressing this or not. Now on loop, what I'm going to do, force is now equals to analog read, and I need to specify where is my cable connected. My cable is connected in the A0 pin. I'm gonna say serial print line, and I'll just say force, and that's it. So we're going to check our code. I'm gonna click verify. We got to save this. Now this checks the code and it sees that there are no errors. So now we can upload this code to our Arduino. And it's uploading the code, and as you can see, it's done uploading. So now let's open our serial monitor. And now as you can see here, we get 0, 0, 0, 0 everywhere, okay? Because now that means that we are actually reading from the input, which is super cool. Now, time for the truth. Let's put our finger on top and see what value we get. 3, 2, 1. Go, look at that beauty. Bye-bye. Go, bye-bye. How cool is this? So that means that now, if I put my phone on top, what's gonna happen? We are going to read pressure. How cool is that? And that's it, we're done, we did it. Okay, now it's time to let Arduino talk to Python, okay? But now we have to program the consequences. So what is going to happen if I pick up my phone? That is the code that I'm going to do. I'm thinking two things. First, I want the computer to yell at me. And second, I would like to be publicly shamed. So I'm going to do something with my Slack channel, okay? So first, let's allow the computer to yell at me. All right, all we have to do is import a library called Serial that allows us to communicate with the Arduino, of course. And then we wait a little bit and we make a loop and we just read, basically, the messages that the Arduino is sending us. That's it, we don't have to do anything else. It's super, super simple. So, I already recorded two files that I'm gonna listen to if I pick up my phone or if I put my phone down. So let me show you what happens if I pick up the phone. 3, 2, 1.
Stop wasting time.
And now if I put the phone down.
Chareso.
Done, that's it. So it's so stupid this. I think it's going to work because I usually listen to music with my headphones while I'm working. So I think if I hear that voice,
stop wasting time,
in my headphones, it's gonna be scary. So that's pretty cool. Now, the last part of this is gonna be social shaming. That means that I'm going to make a little bit more code that is going to send a message to my Slack channel if I am wasting my time, and it's going to send a message to my Slack channel if I am not wasting my time, okay? So, the code is running, Slack is open, let's test it. 3, 2, 1.
Stop wasting time.
And there it is on the Slack channel, Nico is wasting his time. And now we put it back, and what happens?
Chareso.
Hey, Nico is back to work. That's it, done, finish. I know, it's stupid, but it works. As you can see, it works. We are screaming at Nico, and also Nico is being socially shamed on the Slack channel. So I think that this will make Nico more productive than before. We are done. Thank you so much for watching this video. Let me know if you like this kind of content. If you have any Arduino ideas, please leave them in the comments. I would love to build things like this. Thank you again for watching. Don't forget to be happy. Don't forget to eat kimchi. Kamsahamnida. Saranghaeyo.
Stop wasting time.
Bye-bye.